this is how to get them.
Hey, where do you think you're going? Don't you know this show is going soon? Hey, just a few seats left here. It's light and bright outside, there's no moon.
Oh, listen, sister, I love my Mr. Man, and I can't tell you why. There ain't no reason why I should love that man. It must be something that the angels done planned. Fish gotta swim, birds gotta fly. I gotta love one man till I die. Can't help loving that man of mine.
It was composer Jerome Kern who first read Edna Ferber's novel about a Mississippi showboat. And he teamed with a 31-year-old writer named Oscar Hammerstein to turn her epic story into a musical.
They wrote most of the songs of the first act and brought them to Ziegfeld. Who else would you bring them to? He was God. He was the greatest producer of his time. And he was the only man they felt who had the vision and the power and the influence to be able to put it on. Ziegfeld at once leaped to do it.
Showboat was really a step for him that was terrifying. And he loved doing it. And to begin with, it was rather a sad story. And he said, we cannot do this musical with all this sadness. And he was so afraid that people would not like what he was doing because they expected a Follies. They expected laughter and ha-ha and beautiful girls.
It was seismic then, that's for sure. The earth shook. There was this incredible centerpiece of a scene in the first act, the miscegenation scene, which had about eight leading characters all interrelating, no songs, and an incredibly complex political plot about miscegenation.
I understand that you have a miscegenation case on board.
What's it mean, Mom?
How's that?
A case of a Negro woman married to a white man. Criminal offense in this state. Julie Dozier, my information says you were born in Mississippi. Your pop was white, your mammy black. Is that right?
Yes, that's right.
You two better get your things and come along with me.
The lyricist and book writer Oscar Hammerstein chose not to whitewash Ferber's powerful stories, which played out on Captain Andy's showboat, the Cotton Blossom, as it traveled up and down the Mississippi for decades.
I think that before we opened it, Ziegfeld expected showboat to be a pretty big bore, and he thought all that story stuff would be cut out, and what would remain would be the pretty costumes and scenery and the tunes and the girls and the comedian. But I wanted to keep the spirit of Edna's book. Was a sprawling kind of novel. And the one focal influence I could find was the river, the Mississippi. So I decided to write a river theme.
Old Man River, that old man river, he must know something, but don't say nothing. He just keeps rolling, he keeps on
What Oscar Hammerstein did, I think, primarily was to marry European operetta and American musical comedy tradition. And Showboat is the apotheosis of that, in which you tell a story, but unlike European operetta, a serious story, or a story that has some realism, if you want to use such a word, And I think that one of the reasons Showboat turned out as well as it did is that Kern knew what Oscar was trying to do, and he was just as interested in doing it. I'm tired of living.